Let's spell out what this first term means. T plus h plus 1 to the third power. Here comes a trick. I write it as t plus 1 plus h times t plus 1 plus h times t plus 1 plus h. I just reshuffled the different terms. T plus 1 plus h, t plus 1 plus h. And three factors of that sort gives the third power. What do I get? T plus 1 times t plus 1 times t plus 1 is t plus 1 to the third power. Then I get terms of that sort h times t plus 1 times t plus 1. H times t plus 1 times t plus 1 is, of course, the square of t plus 1. How many terms of that sort do I get? H times this one is 1 of that sort. T plus 1 times h times t plus 1, second one, and t plus 1 times t plus 1 times h, a third one. Three terms of that type. Plus, everything else has h square in it. H times t plus 1, or t plus 1 times h, or even h times h times h. So whatever happens to appear next is the square of h times something. So what do we get? 1 over h times t plus 1 to the third power, t plus 1 to the third power, cancels. 3 times h, t plus 1 squared plus h square times something. And look what happens. We divide by h, h divided by h cancels. H square divided by h becomes h. And in the end, we are left with 3 times the square of t plus 1. And this term is negligible. So the answer would be 3 times the square of t plus 1. Of course, you may already know that there's tons of rules how to compute derivatives. In the end, they're just shortcuts of such computations.